Hello, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I welcome you all to this episode of our lessons in Al-Qira'atul Rashida. In our quest to gain some Arabic proficiency, inshallah, I'm hopeful as we are on the topic number 49 in this book, we've seen a lot of vocabularies and expressions, we've saved a lot. Now I'm sure we are quite very strong in the language. But what concerns me most is whether we are practicing or not. Get it? My work will be course 90 if you are not practicing. You are just writing vocabularies and expressions. That's not the goal. If that was the goal, I could just come and then give vocabularies, expressions, and then we are gone. Just as we have vocabularies and expression sessions on the session or playlist on the channel. Though not much. But our goal here is that we see the vocabularies and expressions in a passage so that when we want to make a composition, it will be easy. And then when we want to speak, it will be easy for us. So we need the practice. Be writing essays on your own. Be practicing your vocabularies by speaking with friends and all that. Inshallah. When we do that, inshallah, we will achieve our goal. Okay. Now, we look at this other interesting topic again. Very simple one. The author, he has named it Risalatun ila Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This here is sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, written with that design. Okay. Risala is a message, of course. A message, a letter, all those goes. Risalatun ila Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A message or a letter to the messenger of Allah, may peace and blessings of Allah be upon him. Okay. He says, إِذَا جَاءَكَ قَرِيبٌ أَوْ صَدِيقٌ. This word, we've met it a lot of times. قَرِيب is the singular of أَقَارِب, and that is relative. So إِذَا جَاءَكَ قَرِيبٌ, if a relative of yours comes to you, أَوْ صَدِيقٌ, or a friend. Okay. Now, the جَاءَ, we attach it together with the fa'il right away. We don't have to say إِذَا جَاءَ إِلَيَّ قَرِيبٌ أَوْ صَدِيقٌ. Say إِذَا جَاءَنِي. I can say جَاءَنِي مُحَمَّدٌ الْيَوْمُ. جَاءَنِي مُحَمَّدٌ الْيَوْمُ. We put it together with the مَفْعُولٌ بِهِ. The جَاءَ together, the verb together with the مَفْعُولٌ بِهِ. لِمَاذَا جَاءَكَ هَذَا الرَّجُلُ. Why did this man come to you? You don't necessarily need to say إِذَا جَاءَ. لِمَاذَا جَاءَ إِلَيْكَ. لِمَاذَا جَاءَ إِلَيْكَ هَذَا الرَّجُلُ. The إِلَيْكَ to show to you. لِمَاذَا جَاءَكَ مُبَاشَرَةً with the مَفْعُولٌ بِهِ. So he says إِذَا جَاءَكَ قَرِيبٌ أَوْ صَدِيقٌ. If a relative or a friend comes to you. وَقَالَ, and says, إِنِّي مُسَافِرٌ إِلَى الْوَطَنِ. I am indeed traveling to our hometown. So it's like you've traveled somewhere, you've gone somewhere, and one of you is going back home. Sorry. So you've all traveled, like we are in Ghana, and we've all traveled to Saudi Arabia, we've traveled to UK, to America, and one is coming home. So he comes to me and tells me, I'm going back home. Al-Watan is used specifically for the home country. If I say Watani, my home country, that is where my nationality is. It says, وَقَالَ إِنِّي مُسَافِرٌ إِلَى الْوَطَنِ, and tells you that I'm going back to our country. I'm going back to the country. And he says, سَأُقَابِلُ أَبَاكَ, I will meet with your father. أَبَاكَ, because it is the object in the sentence. At a place you see it أَبُوكَ, if it comes as the fa'il. At times you see it أَبِيكَ, if it comes as ism majrur. Let me give examples of the three, if I say جاء أبوك إلى المدرسة اليوم, your father came to the school today. جاء أبوك. أبوك here is مرفوع بالواو لأنه من الأسماء الخمسة أو الأسماء الستة as some will say it. So أبوك at times can come أبوك when it is the فاعل or when it is the subject مبتدأ. And if I say ذهبت إلى أبيك, because of the إلى it will become أبيك if a preposition precedes it. ذهبت إلى أبيك, I went to your father. And I say رأيت أباك, I saw your father. أباك, because of what? Because it is the مفعول به in the sentence, it is the object in the sentence. Same way here, سأقابل أباك, I will meet your father. أباك is the مفعول به, that's why it came this way. It says فهل توصي بشيء. So if a relative, a friend comes to you and tells you I'm going back to the country, or I'm going back to our home country and I'm going to meet your father, and he's saying that فهل توصي بشيء. توصي here is from the verb أوصى, and أوصى comes with a number of meaning. أوصى can be that he willed, will as in when somebody is dying, what he leaves behind. أوصى بكذا كذا كذا كذا, that he left a will that we should do this. أوصى ب. Okay, and then we say أوصى again, أوصى الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, أوصى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم المسلمين باحترام أبويهم. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has advised Muslims to be dutiful to their parents, or to be respectful to their parents. Now, أوصى here means he has advised or he has cautioned. So أوصى has meanings like that. أوصى again can mean that you giving a message to somebody, to stick to another. فهل توصي بشيء here means that will you give him a message. وهل لك رسالة إليه أحملها. So your friend or relative who comes to you tells you, do you have anything for him? هل توصي بشيء. وهل لك رسالة إليه, do you have a message for him or a letter to him. أحملها, أحمل I carry, from حمل يحمل. أحملها منك, do you have a letter to him that I will carry it from you to him. يعني وأبلغها إليه, أبلغ from بلغ to relay. That's why we say بلغ سلامي إليهم أو بلغهم سلامي, give my greetings to them. Then I'll say, oh, قد بلغت الرسالة. بلغت الرسالة. I have relayed the message. I have sent the message. It says, فلا تشك أنه سيجتمع بأبيك. You see here, بأبيك. Not what? أباك. That's what I was talking about. So it says, فلا تشك أنه سيجتمع بأبيك. You will not doubt, tashukku from shakka, yashukku, tashukku, you will not doubt that he will indeed meet with your father. Sayajitami'u bi'abika, he will meet with your father. Ijtama'atu bihi, I met with him. Warubama, rubama means maybe or perhaps. Warubama yas'alu abuka, you see here, أبوك. So you note that. وربما يسأل أبوك عنك خبرا سارا. And perhaps your father will ask about you خبرا سارا. When you say سارا, we mean that which excites, a happy news, a good news. Perhaps your father will ask to hear a good news about you. يسأل عنك خبرا سارا. He will seek about you a message that excites. He will seek to hear something good about his son. وَبُشْرَى بُشْرَى is glad tidings, good news. وَبُشْرَى صِحَتِكَ and the good news about your health. So if you are somewhere with a friend and the friend tells you, I'm going back to the home country, I'll meet with your father. Your father, when your friend meets him, will definitely ask him, how is my son? How is he doing? I hope work is fine. He will need to hear khabaran, saran, good news, exciting news. وَبُشْرَى صِحَتِكَ and the glad tidings of your health, that your son is fine, he's doing great. Okay. فَتَقُولُ, so you say, تَقْرَأُ عَلَى وَالِدِي مِنِّ السَّلَامِ. تَقْرَأُ here is not to read. To relay greetings to. It says, تَقْرَأُ عَلَى وَالِدِي مِنِّ السَّلَامِ. You give my greetings of peace to my father. It is a lot in the hadith and seerah. If you read, you hear, أَقْرِوهُ مِنِّ السَّلَامِ. اذهب الى جاري كذا 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 واكرهه واكرهه مني السلام. اقرئ is the command form. اقرا to give greetings to. Says تقرا على والدي مني السلام. You give my father greetings of peace. When you listen to the hadith a lot, you hear this thing a lot. اقرئه مني السلام. You hear this a lot. There is a story, I still have it on this channel. I would like you to go to the very earliest videos I posted. Please do that for me. You will see a video about, I think, Salat ala Nabi or something like that. You will see this thing here. وَإِذَا جَاءَ الصَّبَاحِ اِذْهَبْ إِلَى الْقَادِي وَأَكْرُوهُ مِنِّ السَّلَامِ وَكُلَّهُ كَذَا كَذَا. There is a story like that. Please do well and check the video out. You see this أَكْرُوهُ مِنِّ السَّلَامِ being used there. It says وَكُلَّهُ أن ابنك بخير and tell him that your son is doing well. You tell this فتقول, you say to the friend or relative who is going back home, that give my father my greetings of peace and tell him or say to him, إن ابنك بخير, your son is indeed very fine. وكما تحب من صحة وسرور, and just as you want of health and happiness, your son is okay. Okay. So the example I gave about abuka, abaka, abika, you take note of it. It came here at first, sa'uqabilu abaka, because it is what the maf'ulun bihi. And the asma'u sitta or asma'u al-khamsa or al-asma'u al-khamsa, as some put it, some say there are five, some say there are six, depending. Their grammatical analysis is by waw, alif, and yai, not by dhamma, fatha, and kasra, as we are used to. Say marfu wa alamat rafi'i ad-dhamma. No, it's not like that. It is by waw for raf'u, and then alif for nasb, yai for jar. So we see here, sa'uqabilu abaka. Abaka is maf'ulun bihi, is the object in the sentence. So it comes as abaka. Now we come here, it says, sayajtami'u bi. حرف جر أبيك اسم مجرور. So it came أبي. So the ياي here is the sign that it is مجرور. We don't need to see كسرة. Okay. And then again, so here we say أبيك, أبي is اسم مجرور because of the B, preposition B. And then you leave that and you come here. He says وربما, and perhaps, يسأل أبوك. So أبو here is the fa'il, is the dua, and so we realize that it came with waw. So it is marfu alam traf'ihi al waw li'annahu min al asma'i al khamsa aw min al asma'i al sitta kama inda ba'duhum. It says the next paragraph we have kadhalika kana al muslimun. This scenario he has painted, he says kadhalika kana al muslimun, such was how the muslim were, the muslims were. يعتقدون أن الموت, يعتقدون, they have this belief, أن الموت, that the dead, أن الموت, that death, جسر, is kind of a bridge, كوبري, as they say in Egypt, كوبري, يعتقدون أن الموت جسر. They believe that death is a bridge إلى الآخرة, to the hereafter, الآخرة, to the afterlife. جسر is a nice vocabulary, you need to save it, a bridge. وكل من عبر هذا الجسر, and everyone who crosses, عبر, who crosses, there's a difference between عبر, to cross, and عبر, to express. So you take note of the sounds. عبر, there's no تشديد. عبر, there is تشديد العين. The middle letter has been given شدة. So when it is عبر, بمعنى to cross. When you hear عبر, بمعنى to express. I عبر عن نفسه. عبرت عن نفسي. I express myself. But عبر, عبرت البحر. I crossed the sea. Okay. يعبر, عبر يعبر. وكل من عبر هذا الجسر, and everyone who crosses this bridge, من المسلمين, among the Muslims, وصل, he reaches, إلى الآخرة, he reaches the hereafter. واجتمع هنالك, and he meets there. Now, this هنالك, it comes a lot in the Quran. I think there is a verse like هنالك الولاية لله. There is a verse like that. Now, I had received questions on the difference between هناك and هنالك. Now, note that they can be used interchangeably without any serious pressure on ourselves being too extreme. Can be used freely interchangeably. But then, there is something in Arabic language that we call دقة المعاني. It has exactness of meaning. Okay. Or دقة الدلالة. It has exactness of reference. So if he says هنالك, the lamb that has been introduced, if it was هناك, there wouldn't be any lamb here. But هنالك, the lamb is للبعد, lamb البعد. It's showing farthness. هناك is close. We have هنا, here. هناك, there. هنالك, far there. I hope these steps I've given is clear. هنا is here. هناك, there. هنالك, far there. It goes farther than these two that I've said. Okay. So it says, واجتمع هنالك. He means there because it's the hereafter. He uses هنالك. Please learn this from this author. He meets there برسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, with the messenger of Allah, peace and blessings be upon him. وتشرف بزيارته. وتشرف, تشرف means to be honored with. He said تشرفت بلقائك. I'm honored with meeting you. تشرفت بلقائك. تشرفت بمعرفتك. Knowing you is an honor to me. I've been honored with knowing you. So when two friends meet and they talk for the first time, كيف حالك, اسمي كذا, كيف حالك, اين تدرس, من اين انت, كلام كثير, you exchange a lot of حوار, يعني حوار goes on. After that, when you are parting ways, you say تشرفت, like I was honored meeting you. تشرفت بلقائك, I was honored by me, with meeting you. It says تشرفت, وتشرف بزيارته, and this person who has moved to the hereafter is honored with meeting the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. It says ولا بد أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, and it's definitely the Prophet, the Messenger of Allah, peace and blessings be upon him, سائل عن أمته, will ask about his أمة, will ask about his people. ولا بد أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سائل عن أمته. سائل بمعنى سيسأل عن أمته. ولا بد أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سائل عن أمته, بمعنى ولا بد أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سيسأل عن أمته. Take note of this. Okay. And he says ويمكن ألا يصل قريبك أو صديقك إلى الوطن. And it is possible, يمكن, it is possible that your relative or friend, لا يصل, he will not reach, إلى الوطن, to their home country, or he will not reach the country. لمانع لهي is showing reason. لمانع I due to a preventive reason. لمانع مانع is ما يمنعك من فعل شيء ما. مانع something that prevents you from doing something. It's a مانع. So when you are going to work and it starts raining, that is a مانع. The rain is a مانع. When you want to eat but you have injury on your mouth or something you can't eat, that situation is a مانع. Okay, so it says لمانع أو حادثة or an accident due to a preventive reason or an accident. The person may not reach your father. This scenario he painted for us first. He said this person that you have given the message to go to your father and tell him might not reach your father. He says أو يصل إلى الوطن or he might reach the country ولا يجتمع بأبيك and he will not meet with your father. It's possible. It's a possible scenario. ولكن المسلمين but the Muslims ما كانوا يشكون في وصول الميت إلى عالم الآخرة. He says but the Muslims ما كانوا يشكون they were not having any doubt في وصول الميت in the they were not doubting the reaching of the dead to the hereafter. That is, they had no doubt that the dead will definitely reach the hereafter. عالم الآخرة أي معنى the afterlife. واجتماع الشهيد برسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And they had no doubt that a martyr will definitely meet with the messenger of Allah. Peace and blessings be upon him. They had no doubt that the shaheed, a martyr, will meet with the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Says زحف المسلمون إلى الشام. زحف, that is the Muslims marched on to Sham. That is Syria, I think. They marched on to Sham. وكان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أخبرهم. And the messenger of Allah, this time that they marched on to Sham, the messenger was no more with us in life. And but then وكان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أخبرهم. The messenger of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم had informed them. What he informed them as they are going to quote. لتفتحن كنوز كسرى وقيصر. You will definitely open up the treasures of Kisra and Kaiser. These were kings, titles of kings then. Says you will definitely لتفتحنّ. This na is known as tawkid. You will definitely open up kunuza, the treasures of Kisra and Kaiser. You will definitely take over Syria. You definitely take over Sham. And then he said وَقَدْ وَعَدَهُمَا وَعَدَ is to promise. وَقَدْ وَعَدَهُمَا Allah bin Nasri. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had promised them with success. He had promised them that they will definitely be victorious with victory. And Nasr, victory. وَقَالَ وَإِنَّ جُنْدَنَا لَهُمُ الْمَنْصُورُونَ وَإِنَّ جُنْدَنَا لَهُمُ الْغَالِبُونَ. Says, and definitely, they are quoting, and definitely, our army, Jundana, our army are definitely lahumul mansurun. They are those who will win, who will be victorious. Wa inna jundana lahumul ghalibun. And our soldiers or in our army are definitely those who will overcome. Al ghalib, the one who overpowers the other. Wa kanu, and the Muslims. كانوا they were واثقين بالنصر والفتح. واثق is a believer in something. You seriously believe in it. أي وثق به. They had great belief. كانوا واثقين بالنصر والفتح. They were sure of the victory and the opening. Opening بمعنى when a military goes on a campaign to be able to win over a place is called فتح. When you win over the place and it comes under your authority, you've opened up the place. وَكَذَلِكَ كَانَ And such was how it was. كذلك كان. You are going somewhere and somebody tells you, if you go, there will be this, there will be that, there will be that. And you go and you come and that happened. You come and tell the person, كان كما قلت. أو ما قلته كذلك كان. What you said, it was just as you said it. فقد فتحوا. It was just. وكذلك كان. And so was how it is, how it was. فقد فتحوا مدينة بعد مدينة. They had opened up one city after the other. وهزموا جندا بعد جند. And they defeated. Hazama, to defeat. Hazamu, they defeated. Jundan, an army. Ba'da Jundan, after an army. They kept on winning. Waja'a rajulun yawm al-yarmuk ila Abi Ubaida. So in one of these historical days, yawm al-yarmuk, a man came to Abi Ubaidin. A man came to Abi Ubaidatin. A man came to Abi Ubaidah on the day of Yarmouk. That is one of the campaigns, one of the fights they fought then. Radiallahu anhu, may peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, or may Allah be pleased with him. Qa'id al-Muslimin, Abi Ubaidah was the... Why Abi Ubaidah? Because this name here is Mamnu' min al-Sarf. It does not take double vowel. Neither does it take kasra like this. So he was the Qa'id al-Muslimin. He was the commander of the believers, the Muslims. فَقَالَ And he said to him, إِنَّنِي قَدْ تَهَيَّأْتُ لِأَمْرِ تَهَيَّأَ is to be prepared. تَهَيَّأَ So he says, إِنَّنِي indeed I قَدْ تَهَيَّأْتُ I had prepared لِأَمْرِ for my situation. لِأَمْرِ literally for my condition, for my case, for my situation, for my issue, literally. But he explains here and he says, I here means that is, or I, للشهادة, I إنني قد تهيأت للشهادة. I have prepared for martyrdom. الشهادة is martyrdom. فهل لك من حاجة إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So you see the scenario he painted for us. The person is saying that I'm prepared to die in this battle. Do you have any message, oh commander, for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that if I go to the hereafter, I will inform him? فَهَلْ لَكَ مِنْ حَاجَةٍ Do you have any need? حَاجَة, a need. قَالَ أَبُو أُبَيْدَةَ أَبُو أُبَيْدَةَ said, نَعَمْ, yes, تُقْرِئُهُ عَنِّ السَّلَامِ Give him my greetings. Relay my greetings of peace to him. وَتَقُولُ And you say, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ O Messenger of Allah, peace and blessings of Allah be upon you. إِنَّا قَدْ وَجَدْنَا مَا وَعَدَنَا رَبُّنَا حَقًّا Indeed, we've found or we've gotten what our Lord promised us truly. What our Lord promised us is this verse that he brought here. وَإِنَّ جُنْدَنَا لَهُمُ الْمَنْصُورُونَ وَإِنَّ جُنْدَنَا لَهُمُ الْغَالِبُونَ That is the promise of Allah. And the Prophet has told them, لَتَفْتَحُنَّ كُنُوزَ كِسْرَ وَقَيْسَرَ So Abu Ubaidah is telling this man who came to him that when you go, when you die, inform the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that we've indeed gotten what our Lord promised us truly. This brings us to the end of this lesson. I hope it was another journey of vocabulary hunting and then expression hunting. And then I hope you put it into practice. The best way to practice also is to for you to also teach somebody. If you learn here and you think you've gotten it very well, you also teach somebody. Anything that is confusing here for you, you please do well and ask. I am very available to answer questions. I'm very active on WhatsApp. I'm very active on Facebook. I'm very active with my email as well. So if you have any questions, do not hesitate. And then even in the comment section, I'm very active there. The alert pops up and I'll just come around to answer you. And do well and share. If you've not subscribed yet, do well and subscribe. Share for others to also benefits, inshallah. Till we meet again, have a very good time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.